Because he wanted his father's place to be the place that God designated him to be. Where people felt like they could come and they could receive the love and grace of God. So as Jesus taught in Jerusalem that week before Passover, he kept running into the authorities. He kept having to confront the authorities, challenging the way they made life hard for poor people. You know, for some reason, the religious authorities thought that they had a lock on God's grace and forgiveness at that time. In some cases, I'm not too sure that that's changed that much. They worked with the secular authorities to impose taxes. They kept poor people poor while they lined their pockets with money. And they were already well off. That sound familiar? Well, Jesus confronted all of them. He challenged them. His vision of the kingdom of God, which was a kingdom where everybody would have enough and be for always prepared. Everybody would have enough and peace would always be prepared. Everybody had enough. Because they understood that when God blessed them, it was up to them to bless somebody else.
Amen.
The blessings are not just to you. We know that Rome didn't accept rebellion too well, and they wanted people to know that Roman justice was swift and it was also cruel. That's the way they kept people in Jerusalem in line. So just like Pharaoh said to Moses, when he called for freedom, Pharaoh said no to you, Rome said no to Jesus. When he called for justice for everyone, Rome said no. That ain't the way we do things around here. Sometimes some lady around here trying to change things. Who does this Jesus think he is anyway?
No.
Well, Rome said no, but God said yes. God said, Mom, you don't know who you're dealing with. This is my son. These are my people. Enough is enough.
Amen.
How many people here today know that we serve a God who has the ability to lead us from oppression and justice?
Amen.
Jesus never said that anything was going to be quick and easy. But he always makes it well worth our effort to work for justice. Church, Jesus came to earth to bring us good news. And God was not going to let anything on this earth silence that good news. Not even death. God knew it was suffering. And God didn't just come to stop the suffering. God came to suffer with us through the suffering. And because Jesus lives, we can live too.
Amen.
Because Jesus lives, we can face this cruel world every single day.
Amen.
And it's a cruel world, isn't it?
Amen.
Christ broke the bonds of death and hell and rose victorious. Because our God is the kind of God who leads us from death into life.
Amen.
Church, not even death can stop God's will. Not even death can stop God's love, his peace. Not even death can stop God's justice and his abundance that he has for us. As Christians, God's kingdom has taken root in us. That's what we say as Christians, right? Jesus lives in us. So it's up to us to continue to spread the good news. It's up to us to show the world that Jesus still lives. Every time we reach out and love and help somebody who's in need, Jesus rises victorious from the grave. Every time we share the abundance God's given us, you know, it's easy to complain about what we don't have instead of thanking God for what we do. Because we forget that there's always somebody works often.
Amen.
The only way God's kingdom can continue to grow is if we keep reaching out. And then keep teaching other people how to reach out. So they can teach other people how to reach out.
Amen.
And the beat goes on.
Amen.
And we keep doing that until God's love, God's kingdom reaches the ends of the earth. And I can't speak to anyone else. But when God blesses me, it feels so good to be able to bless somebody else. It feels so good to be able to bring joy into somebody else's life that wasn't there before. And usually, it really doesn't take that much. Most people, when they hear the word blessing, they think money. But sometimes just a smile. Sometimes just a kind word or deed. You know, a little financial blessing won't hurt. But it doesn't take much to light up somebody else's life.
Yeah.
Remember, what you do for others eventually comes right back to you.
Yeah.
If we say that Jesus is alive, then the world has to see Jesus living in us. Remember, I said your life should be a sermon.
Yeah.
As you walk around, people are watching you. They're watching what you do, they're watching what you say. You have to be careful.
Amen.
Now, gospel reading today, early on Sunday morning while we spoke of Mary Magdalene went to the tomb where Jesus had been buried, and she found that the stone had been rolled away from the tomb. So she went to tell her disciples that they had taken the Lord's body out of the tomb, and she didn't know what they had done. Now, this is something. Who in the world wants to look dead body? I mean, what could a dead body do for anybody? So the disciples go in and they find the linen wrappings that cover Jesus still laying there. And the cloth that covered Jesus' head folded up and laid someplace else. Even then they still didn't understand the scriptures that said that Jesus must rise from the dead. So they went home. Mary stayed behind and stood outside the tomb. Then she knelt down and looked in his eyes, she saw two angels dressed in white. She asked her why she was crying. She told her before that someone had taken her master's body. She didn't know where it was. So Mary turned and saw a man standing behind her, whom she supposed to be the guardian, because she didn't recognize Jesus at first. Then Jesus called her by name. When she heard his voice, she recognized him. After she saw that it was Jesus, she went to the disciples and said, I've seen Jesus. He's alive. You know what? We're a lot like Mary and Joseph, right? We're a lot like him. We can't always see Jesus because we're looking for him in a grave on the cross. We can't always recognize Jesus because he doesn't always look the same. We're looking in all the wrong places and in all the wrong ways to find him. He's not there. He's risen. He's seated at the right hand of his Father in heaven. So if you want to see Jesus, look at his word. Because if you do, he'll reveal himself to you just like he did to Mary.
Amen.
Read his word. Trust his word. Obey his word. Read his promises to those of us who believe. Church, it's going to be up to us as Christians to let the world know that Jesus, our Savior, is not in the grave. And he's still alive.
Amen.
We serve a risen Savior.
Amen.
So as his disciples, Jesus must live through each of us every day. He has to be visible in our lives in everything that we do. We have to learn to take a stand against anything that goes against the word of God. Many awesome and life-changing events that have happened right here in this Matthew, the ones that even turn our heads sometimes, We have new people coming in, new programs being started, more people stepping up to the plate to accomplish our goals, people looking out for other people. When there is a visible need in the church, we come together. We come together like a good team. It's because Jesus is coming alive in us.
Amen.
And we notice that we aren't taking each other for granted like we used to, but that we're slowly realizing all the wonderful people and all the wonderful gifts which God has blessed this congregation. We're slowly realizing that we're all different. And you know what? That's okay. It's really good. We're realizing that other people don't have to be just like us. That other people don't have to always do things the way we do. Or want the same kind of things that we want all the time. We're slowly realizing that there's more than one way to get there.
Amen.
And we can allow each other to be who we are and do things the way we do them and still accomplish our goal. Because Jesus lived in different ways. And church, as we continue to live into our baptismal vows, Jesus will continue to build in us.
Amen.
He promised to do it. If you ever think that things are so bad in your life, that all hope is gone, then stop and think about why are we here celebrating this resurrection morning. Think about what God did for us through Jesus Christ. Think about what God did for Jesus, even after they killed him. 3 days later, on resurrection morning, he brought back from the dead. See, that's the kind of God that we serve.
Amen.
If God could bring Jesus back from the dead, just think of what he can do in our lives. If we just give him a chance.
Amen.
God wants everybody. He wants all of us to be his disciples. He wants us. He wants to live in our hearts. You see, there's not much we can do. We just have to learn to take a stand. We have to let, if Jesus is living inside of us, then we'll do what's right. Now, none of us are perfect. We're going to make mistakes. Okay? So, let's not kill people because they make a mistake. And while they're trying to turn their lives around, give them a hard time. That's not going to work. God is not happy with that. And especially with the church. Because God wants us to love each other. Love each other like we love ourselves. Love is what it's all about. And we show that love to each other daily as we go out into the world, as we approach people, learn how to speak to people, learn how to talk to people. You know, there are many people, you know, we get these things in our minds about certain people, a certain way, approaching each person differently. Because each person has different gifts, different talents. You never know what you're going to get from. God blesses you as you bless other people, and he just keeps going. You can't imagine the blessings that God can give you, or God will give you, if all you do is do what the Word says. First, you have to know the Word. First, you have to know the Word. You know, yesterday we had to, The older kids were answering questions, and it was Cassandra, right? Getting them all right. And the deputy said, well, how do you know all the answers? She said, because I couldn't pop the stuff. Yeah, man. You can do your Bible study at home, but do it. Do it. It's important that you know God's word.
Amen.
You can't do what you're not tell you. Jesus is alive and he has